Could you explain the process of NRC when it is covered for all over the country? Because all sorts of nonsense are spread by the opposition parties and the media people. Because the kind of questions the papers do, if you don't have, all kinds of fear-mongering is done. Especially beyond the politicians, the mainstream media is doing that.
Yes.
This is the one question. The second is, what sort of action can be taken against the media people who intentionally spreading misinformation, and it is going beyond any limit, sir. Thank you, sir.
First of all, I don't know what the NRC is because nobody knows. Because we have not come out with a draft of NRC yet. We have only given the concept. And but when the draft comes, then we can have it vetted. Of course, we'll send it to the law ministry and get a clearance from them that it has been drafted according to the constitution. The constitution will protect anyone from for their constitutional rights. So NRC cannot take away anybody's constitutional rights. But so these people who are speaking about NRC, ask them to produce a draft. Tell us which draft are you relying on. They will not be able to. But you see, this cinema culture has spoiled everybody. So anything can be said at any time with a suitable dialogue to follow it. So I think, as far as the media is concerned, the more sensational the news, the better for them. They sell the papers better. The media TRPs go up. So how many media people can you catch? And then there will be screams, oh, there's a, you know, suppression, so on. So I would say that if you ever come across any utter falsehood being uttered by media, please get hold of some friend of yours who's a lawyer and ask them to file a case for 5 crores damages. And you'll become rich also, and they will also learn a lesson. I have done that with many newspapers, so nowadays no newspaper wants to publish anything about me because they're afraid. File a case against them.
But then this has to be done by the government, sir, because
government does that, then there'll be a bigger howl. See, what we have done, we have just tried to maintain law and order in Jawaharlal Nehru University. And Jawaharlal Nehru University is a stinking hole. I want it to be closed down for 2 years, and everything, everybody evicted, and then lot of DDT put there to clean it up. And otherwise it's a, it has been, you know, people have been living in hostels for 10 rupees a month for 30 years and 40 years and doing their politics. They don't mind failing over and over again. And so I think JNU is an example. And see what a hullabaloo they have created. And let the police report come out, you will be shocked. You will find that terrorist organization as PFI and all have got involved. This government is the despair of all terrorists. You see, the Narendra Modi's record in fighting terrorism is so good, it's not publicized. It's not only that we have not been able to rebut bad news, but even good news we have not been able to put out. There used to be 300, 400 deaths a year due to terrorist firing in Kashmir. Now it is down to 9. And in Kashmir, 0 in the last 3 years. But there is no publicity for it. So, of course, it's the fault of the government. Because they have got party spokesmen who don't read and write, and therefore they only go and say, utter the usual stuff. You need people who will study and analyze and then go and speak on it.
As someone was moved with both of you and was derived so much of guts from you people, நீங்க பின்னாடி இருக்கிற முன்னாடி இருக்கேன்னா ஒரு தைரியம் இருக்கும். இப்ப நீங்க சொன்ன மாதிரி அந்த 5 கோடின்றது அது டாக்டர் சுவாமியோட பிராண்ட், அதனால. பட் இப்போ எங்களுக்கு ஸ்பெஷலி தமிழ்நாடுல எங்களை பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் சோ மச் ஆஃப் ஆன்டி நேஷனல் இவ்வளவு மோசமா இருந்ததே கிடையாது. இந்த பர்டிகுலர் இதுக்கு ஏன் டாக்டர் சுவாமியோ டாக்டர் சந்திரலேகாவோ ஒரு லீட் எடுத்து எங்களுக்கு வை கான்ட் தே லீடர்ஸ் திஸ் இஸ் பிகமிங் அ வெரி வெரி பேட் ஸ்டேட். அவ்வளோ மோசமாக இருக்குது தமிழ்நாடு. நாங்களே எவ்வளோ சின்ன சின்ன எவ்ரி செகண்ட் பர்சன் பிகம்ஸ் அ தலைவர் ஹியர். அதில் எவ்ரி செகண்ட் பர்சன் ஒரு படம் நடிச்சுட்டா ஒரு படம் டைரக்ட் பண்ணிட்டாங்க. opinion maker nenchikra adula. So you know, you are not able to fight them. Adhe why can't someone was moved with both of you, and someone was derived a lot of guts and was learned a lot from you both. This is I would like to you people, because I think only you people are fit enough to do that.
உதாரணம் கொடுக்க முடியும் உங்களுக்கு இதை பற்றி. இன் 1991 சந்திரசேகர் வாஸ் பிரைம் மினிஸ்டர், வாஸ் எ சீனியர் மோஸ்ட் மினிஸ்டர், டூ போர்ட்ஃபோலியோ தட் டைம், ஃபார்மர்ஸ் அண்ட் லா. ஸோ ஹீ டோல்ட் மீ தட் திஸ் கருணாநிதி இஸ் பாசிங் ஆல் ஸ்டேட் சீக்ரெட்ஸ் தட் வி ஷேர் வித் ஹிம் டு தி எல்டிடி, தட் இஸ் ஷேர் ஸ்டேட் சீக்ரெட்ஸ் வி ஷேர் அபவுட் எல்டிடி டு தி எல்டிடி. So, what shall we do? So I said, you give him a warning, and if he does it again, then dismiss the government. So he did it again. So I now told the Prime Minister, you dismiss the government. So we had a cabinet committee on, which is a subcommittee of the cabinet on security matters, where all the IB and the Intelligence Bureau, everybody, I mean, are all present, and only two or three ministers who are senior most are present. And the question came up, what shall we do? And I pressed that dismiss the government. Karunanidhi at that time, out of 232 seats in the assembly, he had 210 or something like that. It was a huge majority. And he was part of some national front or something like that. And Chandrasekhar looked at the officers. They said, no, rivers of blood will flow, independent Tamil Nadu will be created, and this and that. So I told them that you have a choice, either to have rivers of blood or you have a separate Tamil Nadu, because Karunanidhi is planning to secede the country with the help of the LTTE. So finally Chandrasekhar said, you take charge of it, I'll give you full powers. So I arrived here and put myself up in this Connemara hotel, and then plotted this, that we will dismiss the government and hold fresh elections. And there was that time a DGP called Dorai, I think, he committed suicide later. I called him and I asked him, we plan to dismiss this government, and I don't want any buses to be burnt and peace to be maintained. Can you do that? He said, well, I'll have to then resort to police firing. I said, yes, go ahead, fire. He said, people will be killed, and then there'll be a commission inquiry and all that. So I took out a pad from my pocket and wrote on it, on behalf of the government, I authorize you to kill up to 5,000 people for maintaining law and order. And I said, show this to all the police stations and get hold of all the history charge sheeters, list which police stations have, and say that you have got orders to shoot to kill. And then anything happens, the commission inquiry comes, you give them this letter saying that this Dr. Swami, on behalf of the government, who ordered us. You will be surprised that not only no bus was burnt after dismissal, but even a cycle was not burnt. And I searched for Mr. Karunanidhi, where he had gone. He had gone to Oliver Road, hid himself, and put a lock outside of the door so that people think nobody is at home. So finally, I sent somebody there to tell him that we have no intention of arresting him. I will tell you, this Tamil Nadu, all these fellows, they are a terrible minority. If the central government decides to crack down, they will not stand here, because the majority of the people in Tamil Nadu want peace and quiet. They want to pursue their life in peace and quiet. And therefore, I don't have to stand for election here. If tomorrow Tamil Nadu things really get bad, I will start putting pressure on Mr. Narendra Modi to dismiss the government here, whether it's this government or that government, I don't care. But any government which allows ISIS, PFI, all these people to carry out anti-national activities in Tamil Nadu, they have to be taught a lesson. Just as LTT was taught a lesson, the same way these people have to be taught a lesson. It is not the question of lack of political representatives, it's a lack of guts and that you must teach your children that. Otherwise, most of the mothers will say, "Ayyo, in the bumble is coming out long." Thane vele paathen pongo, jilam arisil vadi gan ko panna panna ala the uttu gun ones. That is the mentality that we have today. You infuse fear into your children. Instead of that, infuse courage. Tell them to be rational, not irrational in the use of courage. But I think Tamils have a long history of fighting. The Cholas, Pandyans, even the Tirumala Nayakas, they did such valorous acts to keep Tamil Nadu safe from foreign invaders. We seem to have lost this culture when the British came and made you all into clerks. So that we have to now go back to our old Tamil culture and revive the spirit of fighting for your rights.
Good morning, sir. My name is Srinath. I've been a great fan of your recent writings, including your book Reset. So my first question is, if the economy continues to disintegrate, how likely is it that all the illegal Bangladeshis voluntarily go back and Bangladesh implements its own CAA?
Well, Indian economy will not be permanently in a bad shape. Because we were in bad shape in 1965 when we were almost on starvation. And very soon afterwards we had Green Revolution. In 1990 when I became minister, we were about to default on foreign exchange payments. And overnight it all changed and we started growing at 8% per year under the leadership of Mr. Narasimha Rao. So India is never going to come down to that kind of position where people want to leave this country. Most people come, this is a very unique country. We have still democracy. And democracy, by the way, is inside the hearts of the people, not because of our education. When Mrs. Gandhi declared election in 1977, At that time I had escaped twice to America. The second time I escaped. After landing in America, suddenly Mrs. Gandhi announced elections. So I said, I'm going to go back. So all my colleagues at Harvard University told me, why you want to go back? Democracy is not for poor people, where you have such a large population of poor people. Only the educated people understand what democracy is. Mrs. Gandhi is sure to win the election. Now, when the results came out, I found all the educated South voted for Indira Gandhi. But it was the uneducated North which voted her out and defeated her also. And that's how we got democracy back. So this ancient culture of ours, whether you are educated in English or not, it doesn't matter. That Indian tradition has always been democratic. And therefore, many of the things, the qualities we have, these will one day be the factors which will bring us back to a fast economic growth. So you don't worry about that. And of course, if Modi comes to to a new realization and makes me finance minister, I'll do it in 1 month.
Good morning, sir. My name is Puneet Kumar.
Yes.
Sir, there are two questions. First, what and who is stopping you to be FM? And secondly, when we would print our gods in our currency notes?
Yes, that's a good question. As far as who becomes minister, it's always the prime minister. But I have a disqualification. I'm not only an economist, but I'm also a politician. And all politicians are always worried that you appoint somebody who will do well, then he'll now become contented for your seat also. So I think many of the people are telling Modi, be careful of Swami. Once he will improve the economy, then he will say, Modi, you better leave now. I can be a better prime minister also. So that fear factor is the reason why I'm not becoming finance minister.
So the currency notes?
Currency notes, you want God's image. That would be an insult to God, no?
No, it's not insult to God, because Muslim country won't...
Oh, Muslim country can do it, but we can't stop them.
No, but in our they won't own print country, our notes. They won't
print. On a rupee note, which is going in the hands of smugglers and black marketeers and so on. Now, I don't know whether we want it. You see, we want our freedom to be good Hindus. We don't want that, anything more than that. But the state should be done as we have done in the past, except the time of Ashoka. India was always a secular, and of course these invaders who came, Mughals and the British. India was always a secular country. We never discriminated on anybody's thing because we believe in a Sarva Dharma Samabhava. That means all religions are equal and they all religions lead to God. So I don't think we want the state machinery to reflect the majority status of Hindus in our country. We can do without. We are building temples all over. You want anywhere to temple to be built, let me know. Because I'm about to now embark on Krishna Janmabhoomi and Kashi Vishwanath. And you must note that one very good thing came out of Ram Mandir litigation. The Muslim population has accepted the Supreme Court judgment, except for a few leaders here and there. The broad masses of the Muslims said, we have lost in the court, the matter ends there. So, as long as we work on constitutional principles, we can continue to have our religion flourish without necessarily putting it in the currency.
Suprabhatam Subramanya Swamiji. I am from Shiv Sena. I am a learning politician.
Which Shiv Sena?
From this. I am a proud Shiv Senik of Tamil Nadu, Chennai.
But
I know that once again, I just want to ask
not
a question,
Maharashtra.
Sir. Tamil Nadu is a registered.
Are you connected to the Shiv Sena of
Maharashtra? Bala Sahib, Hindu Hruday Sabrat, Bala Sahib Thakre ji.
Alright.
So I have a question, sir. I know that our party, Shiv Sena party, voted in favor of CAA in Lok Sabha.
Yes.
And we remain neutral by not voting either in favor of CAA or against CAA.
Yes.
But as far as I know, as a learning politician, as a proud citizen of this India, that whatever laws are passed in Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha become an act. But I am confused to see that the Kerala Chief Minister passes a resolution on the Citizenship Amendment Act that the people of Kerala are against this. So I find some kind of treachery in this. This is treason. So instead of always recommending emergency or just removing the government in Tamil Nadu, 30 Hindutva Karyakartas were brutally murdered in Kerala. Why don't you straight away dismiss the Kerala government? This cannot happen in this country. And I'm proud, Shiv Sainik, I'm proud to say that not even single minority should be left in that Pakistan and Bangladesh. I want everybody, because for every square kilometer there are only 250 Pakistanis. But in India we have 440 people. And I don't mind if Amir Khan or Ria Mirza would like to go
speech,
to Pakistan. Huh? Thank you.
The speech only I can give you. First of all, what did the Kerala Assembly resolution say? Can you tell me what it said? Kerala Assembly. Did you read the Kerala Assembly resolution?
Yes, sir. I would like to hear from you.
No, no. What did it say? What did the Kerala Assembly say?
It says that the entire Kerala populace are against Citizenship Amendment.
No,
correct me if I'm wrong.
It didn't say that. You have not read it. That's the problem with giving speeches, you see. You must read. Go home and go to the download from the website of the Kerala Assembly, the exact text. What it said is that this act that the Government of India has passed in Parliament is not acceptable, full stop, and the Government of India should withdraw this amendment. It did not say that we will not implement it. If it had said that we will not implement this, then Article 356 can be applied and the Kerala government can be dismissed. Secondly, about the killings that are taking place, we have to make out a case because there is a Supreme Court judgment called the Bommai judgment. Under which circumstances you can dismiss a government? Now, I cannot accuse the Chief Minister without having any evidence whatsoever that he directed the killing of RSS people or Shiv Sena people or anybody, but that it was not done by PFI, it was not done by Marxist cadres, all that, and then dismiss the government, an elected government. They will go to court and they will be vindicated. So what I have to do is to see that this those who are doing the murders, we catch them. In the last 6 months, I have not heard of any RSS man being killed in Kerala, because those killers know what will be the consequences. So therefore, that is what we need to do. We have to create an environment where people can live freely. In Kerala, the communists are in power, but now the communists have lost everywhere in the country. They were, you know, lost in the world also. They used to say there is no inflation in Soviet Union, there is no unemployment in Soviet Union, there is no poverty in Soviet Union. Now there is no Soviet Union also. So therefore, they are contracting. Now they are getting one. Their national vote is only 1.5%. So don't worry about them. They are on the way out. So get ready for the cremation ceremony of the Communist Party.
Sir, good morning. Sir, Sandhya. Sandhya from Perambur. சார், இது ஒரு சின்ன டவுட்டு. நம்ம வந்து இது ஆக்சுவலாக வந்து நீங்கள் வந்து மற்றவங்களுக்கு ஆன்சர் கொடுக்கணும். ஆக்சுவலாக நம்மளை கேட்குறாங்க, என்ன கேட்குறாங்கன்னா, என்னென்னவோ பண்ண வேண்டியிருக்கு நாட்டில், இதெல்லாம் விட்டுட்டு எம்ப்ளாய்மெண்ட்டுக்கு வழி பண்ண தெரியல, அதை பண்ண தெரியல, இதை பண்ண தெரியல, அதெல்லாம் விட்டுட்டு இதையே நோண்டுறாங்க, இவங்களால கவனமே இருக்க முடியாதா?
அமைப்புல நம்ம வந்து முழுக்க தோல்வி தான் பெற்றோம். அதனால அதில் வந்து நீங்கள் வந்து விவாதம் பண்ண வேண்டாம். இட் இஸ் அ ஃபேக்ட் that the economy, we have miserably failed to, and there are reasons for it, and it can be turned around. And I'm sure that if the crisis gets any bigger, even the Prime Minister will be forced to take those steps by which the things can improve. It's not that we haven't had crises in the past. Munnaliyum crisis irundhirukke pala. 1990 la VP Singh pannittu poitar, adukapra nanga vandhom சரியாக்கினோம். நரசிம்மராவும் அதை வந்து பெரிய அளவுக்கு சரியாக்கினார். அதே மாதிரி வந்து சைனா அட்டாக் அப்புறம் வந்து டிஃபென்ஸில் வந்து நம்ம மிகப்பெரிய தோல்வி பெற்ற பிறகு இப்போ இன்றைக்கி என்ன பெரிய இராணுவம் நம்மளோடது இருக்குது. அவர் ஆர்மி இஸ் நவ் த ஃபோர்த் லார்ஜஸ்ட் இன் த வேர்ல்டு. ஸோ அதனால அதுக்கப்புறம் நாங்கள் எப்பயும் தோக்கவில்லை. நாலு வாட்டி பாகிஸ்தானோட வார் இருந்த பிறகு நாலு நம்ம ஜெயித்தோம். ஆகவே I would say that you should be, don't argue on things which you can't argue. For instance, on the economy, it's not defensible. The government has failed. But the economy, this is not the only thing. We have done extremely well in protecting our country. We have taught Pakistan a lesson twice, one by surgical strike and then by that attack on Pulwama, where we blew up all their terrorist factories. We have tried to bring in national integration in a big way. We have defended the rights of Hindus by and those who are religiously persecuted by bringing in a law. Yes, unemployment irke, idirke, adirke, varma irke, all this is there. And we admit that we have not followed policies by which we could quick, but just wait a little more. And it's better than having a government which is constantly stealing our money, just like the previous UPA did. And all of them now are on bail, and soon will be in jail. So therefore, that is no alternative. There is no alternative. There's only one of us, and we got to improve, and we will improve.
Namaskar, sir. My name is Kanna Nattinagar. Hindutva and special Tamil Nadu pathi pesirukkar, sir.
Sollunga.
பிரச்சனை என்னன்னாக்க, இந்த 70s 80s இருந்த யங் பிரெயினை வந்து பிரெயின் வாஷ் பண்ணி இந்த ஹிந்துஸையே வந்து ஹிந்துஸை எதிர்த்து பண்றவங்களெல்லாம் சப்போர்ட் பண்ற மாதிரி பண்ணிட்டாங்க. இதை நம்ம வந்து எப்படி காப்பாத்தி திருப்பி கொண்டு வரப்போம்?
அது உண்மைன்னா இந்த கோயில் எல்லாம் இத்தனை பெரிய கூட்டம் இருக்கு தமிழ்நாட்டுல. நாட்டுல தமிழ்நாட்டுல மக்கள் வந்து சும்மா வாய்ப்பு தெரிஞ்சு உட்கார்ந்துருக்காங்க. எதுக்கா இந்த வம்புன்னு வீட்ல இருந்து வெளியில வர்றது இல்ல, போட்டு போடுறது இல்ல, பணம் கொடுத்தா கொடுக்காட்டா ஓட்டு கொடுக்கறது இல்ல. இது மாதிரி எல்லாம் அந்த கெடுதல் காரணம் தான் இன்னைக்கு சில பொர்க்கீஸ்கள் எல்லாம் சேர்த்து உங்களை வந்து மறுத்ததுக்கு அளவுக்கு அவளுக்கு தெப்பு வந்துருக்கு. ஆகவே நீங்கள் எல்லாரும் வெளியில் வாங்கோ, எல்லாரும் வந்து எலெக்ஷன் ப்ராசஸில் டேக் பார்ட். ஆனால் நல்ல கேண்டிடேட் நின்னா அவருக்கு வந்து உதவி பண்ணுறதுக்காக நீங்களே போய் அவருக்கா பிரச்சாரம் பண்ணுவோம் அவர் கேட்கறோ இல்லையோ
இந்த கோவில்லயே வந்து திருட்டு பண்றது வந்து முஸ்லிம்ஸோ கிறிஸ்டியன்ஸோ வேற ஜாதிக்காரால விட இந்த மக்கள் தான் பண்றாங்க, ஹிந்துஸ் தான் பண்றாங்க.
சபாநாயகர் நடராஜ் கோவில்ல வந்து டிஎம்கே தன கையில ஆட்சி வந்து தன கையில எடுத்து சுப்ரீம் கோர்ட்ல போய் நான் அத வந்து அவளுக்கு விடுதலை பண்ணி கொடுத்தேன். அதே மாதிரி இப்போ திருப்பதிக்கும் நான் வந்து செயல்படுறேன், கேஸ் போட்டிருக்கேன். எல்லா கோவிலையும் கவர்மெண்ட் வந்து அடுக்கணும்னா வந்து இந்த மோசடி நடந்ததுக்கு அந்த மோசடி நடந்ததுக்கு அதுக்காக கவர்மெண்ட் வந்து அதில் வந்து ஃபினான்ஷியல் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட்காக அதை வந்து இன்டர்ஃபியர் பண்ண முடியும்னு சொன்னால் நான் சுப்ரீம் கோர்ட் வந்து என்ன கட்டளை வாங்கியிருக்கேன்னா 3 வருஷத்துக்குள்ளே இதை பண்ணி திருப்பி கொடுத்துடணும். இங்கே வந்து வருஷம் வருஷமாக வந்து கவர்மெண்ட் வந்து இதை வச்சுட்டு அதை வந்து அதோட இருக்கிற சொத்தை வந்து சுரண்டி வச்சு அதை வந்து யார் யாருக்கும் கொடுக்கலாலோ கொடுக்கலாலோ அவ வந்து எம்எல்ஏலாம் எல்லாருக்கும் இடமும் கிடச்சிருக்கு, நிலம் கிடச்சிருக்கு. அது மாதிரி வந்து நம்ம வர இந்த இந்த நம்மள அது நம்மளோட வரலாற்று அதை மாற்றணும். அதுக்காக வந்து நீங்கள் கோயிலுக்கும் போங்க, அங்கே வந்து புஜாரிகளை பார்த்து எல்லாம் வாழ்க்கை சொல்லுங்க, வந்து கோயிலோட பேர் ஒன்று கொஞ்சம் பெருசாக ஆக்கிறதுக்காக நியாயமாக வந்து நீங்கள் செயல்பட வேண்டும், ஒரு உதாரணமாக வரணும். அப்படி நீங்களே வந்து கற்றுக் கொடுங்குவா வாழ்க்கை. ஆனால் கோயிலுக்கு வந்து கவர்மெண்ட் கைப்பற்றக்கூடாது, அது அந்த சட்டத்துக்கு கொண்டு வரதுக்கு நான் முயற்சி பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கேன்.
அதோ அதோட இந்த சிலை திரட்டும் சார்,
இது
ஸ்டாச்சு
அது அது மேலே குருவி உட்காந்துட்டு என்ன பண்ணுறாங்கன்னு நல்லா தெரியும். அது யார் இந்த ஸ்டாச்சுஸை வந்து ப்ரொடெக்டே பண்ண முடியாது, எல்லா இடத்துலையும் ஸ்டாச்சுஸ் பண்ணி வச்சுடுறா. அது வந்து அதை நம்ம எப்படி நிறுத்த முடியும்? தஞ்சாவூர்ல வந்து ஒரு ஒரு கோயில் இருந்து ஒரு நடராஜ் ஸ்டாச்சு திருட்டு பண்ணி போய் லண்டன்ல வந்து ஆக்ஷன் பண்ண பார்த்தா நாங்களையும் கேஸ் போட்டு அதை வாபிஸ் கொண்டு வந்திருக்கேன் தஞ்சாவூர். ஸோ அது அதுக்கெல்லாம் இது சி இதெல்லாம் வந்து இந்த வியாதி நம்ம நாட்டில் நிறைய ஸ்மால் பாக்ஸ் இருக்கு, இனிமேல் ஸ்மால் பாக்ஸே கிடையாது, ஜாஸ்தியே இல்லை. நம்ம நாட்டில் இந்த வியாதி இருக்கு அந்த வியாதி இருக்குன்னு அந்த விவரம் கொடுத்துருந்தேன்னா அப்புறம் ராத்திரி தூங்க முடியாது. ஸோ லுக் அட் த பாசிட்டிவ் சைட் ஆல்சோ, இதெல்லாம் நடந்திருக்கோ அதுலேருந்து அதையும் வந்து சில சமயம் சொல்ல வேண்டும்.
டாக்டர் சுவாமி நமஸ்காரம், மை நேம் இஸ் சுரேஷ். சார் ஹியர்.
Yes.
Thank you, right, yeah. So what would have been the consequence or the impact if the CAA text had used the words prosecuted minorities instead of using the specific religions, given the fact that you're saying that there
prosecuted.
Are
no... Prosecuted, what do you mean by prosecuted?
Persecuted minorities.
Persecuted by what? This United Nations only recognizes religious persecution.
Yeah, religiously persecuted minorities instead of the religions themselves, given the fact that you're saying that there are no Muslims who are claiming citizenship in India based on that.
Yes.
So wouldn't that have been easier to pass or people to accept
it? That's hypocrisy, you see. I mean, you people are satisfied with just the terminology change. I'm surprised.
No, it's not just...
What does it mean?
No, it is...
The fact is that the Hindus are persecuted. The fact is
true.
Christians are persecuted. Buddhists are persecuted, Parsis are persecuted.
No,
they are all different religions. This is not Hindu religion.
Isn't it also?
You just because Muslims have been left out, I have to change my entire terminology.
No, it's not right because the Muslims are...
Then what else is it?
It is a perception battle also.
What?
It is a perception battle also.
Perception? Yeah. Perception of what? Jawaharlal Nehru University? I don't care.
It's not
you
just...
read it and you find out whether these are people who deserve to be called in that category, that's it. I can't change the language just because that is a smart way of doing it. I don't want to fool the people. I want them to know that Hindus are being persecuted. They will be looked after in this country.
Sir, namaste, sir. Krishnan from here. Namaste.
Yes.
Sir, எனக்கு ரெண்டு டவுட் இருக்கு சார். அதாவது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வந்து ஃபார் தி கவர்மெண்ட் வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஐ அம் கன்கிராஜுலேட்டிங் ஃபார் பிரிங்கிங் திஸ் லெஜிஸ்லேஷன் CAA. பட் ரெண்டு நாள் முன்னாடி ஒரு தேசிய வார இதழ், அதாவது ஒரு ஃபைனான்சியல் டெய்லியில் நான் பார்த்தேன், இந்த மாதிரி பெரிய ஃபைவ் ஸ்டேட்ஸ் வந்து இதை வந்து இம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் பண்ண மாட்டோம் அப்படின்னு ஒரு அனௌன்ஸ்மெண்ட் கொடுக்கறதா ரிப்போர்ட் பண்ணியிருக்கேன்.
வந்து எப்படி நம்ப முடியும் எழுதி கொடுக்க சொல்லுவோம்? அந்த கவர்மெண்ட் எந்த கவர்மெண்ட் வந்து இம்ப்ளிமெண்ட் பண்ண மாட்டோம்னு எழுதி கொடுக்க சொல்லுங்களோ வீல் டிஸ்மிஸ் Is it a credible threat? 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 Is it a credible We told them, don't have anything to do with LTT, he didn't listen. We dismissed the government.
Sir, there is a rest part, but they are, this, very good things are being done by this government for the nationalist thing. But are we, will we lose it because of the political formation?
That is the strength of the opposition. They are making black into white, white into black, and we have to learn some lessons from that. I agree with you that we need to be, our propaganda should be much better than it is. And there are some structural problems within our party why this is not happening. I think one or two knocks that we get will make us wake up and rectify the situation. This is not a long-term problem for us.
Thank you, sir.
Sir.
Thank you.
Sir, here, sir. Sri Guru Mahasaya, Anandranga Ramanthana, Chennai. இந்த கொஸ்டின் வந்து ரிகார்டிங் சிஏஏல இந்த புதுசாக கிளம்பியிருக்கிற இந்த 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 மேட்டர் பற்றி எக்ஸ்பர்ட்ஸாக இருக்கிற பிரகாஷ் ராஜ், அருந்ததி ராய், இவாலெல்லாம் வந்து இவா தேர் கிரியேட்டிங் ஸோ மச் ஆஃப் மிஸ்இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் டு யங் பீப்புள் ஹூ ஹவன் ரெட். We are honest, if you haven't read. பட் இவால எப்படி டாக்கிள் பண்ணுறது எல்லா பிரச்சனைக்கும் கவர்மெண்ட் அகேன்ஸ்டாக இவ கிளம்பிட்டா இது என்ன பண்ணுறது? செகண்ட் ஒன், இந்த ஏர் இண்டியாவோட இஷ்யூனால அதை பற்றியெல்லாம் வந்து எதுவும் அதை குவைட்டாக அமைக்கிறதுக்கு இந்த சிஏஏ இந்த டைமிங்கா, இல்லை அடுத்த வருஷம் அப்புறமா கூட கொண்டு வந்திருக்கலாமா, இல்லை ஏன் சிஏஏ வந்து இந்த வருஷம் இப்போ தான் கொண்டு வரணும் அப்படின்றத அது வந்து அது டிசைட் பண்ணது வந்து ஏர் இண்டியாவோட
எதிர்பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கோம் 1950.
But
this delay, it will come 2016, again delay.
Economy, we have failed in this hotel. But you have giving so much reset.
That is agreed. That I have told you, we have failed in the economy. There is no question about it. I have no doubt. But I can also tell you that we can rectify it. And some of us are working to see whether the Prime Minister can be persuaded to change the methods that he has adopted so far in dealing with the economy. He changes that, and so that there can be change brought in, real change brought in, and the matter is rectified. That's another matter. But in so many areas we have succeeded, and there's no appreciation, then of course your lack of appreciation of the economy becomes meaningless.
Sir, in the break India forces, in the Arundhati Roy Madri
Alla, sir, in the not love the Jananayagat love the Idmadi Yarna Pesala or Papesa Turno,
NRC get a poison on last NRC get a cake and
both poison of the Karma Vidi Lavde or Ganala Dikari Yamada. The requirement for as far as Assam is concerned because of the Supreme Court direction. But we say, why only Assam? We say that we want to do it in every state. And the Supreme Court is not objected to it. If you are going to target foreigners in Assam, why can't you also target foreigners in other parts of India? And therefore, there in Karnataka, I know that a lot of Rohingyas have turned up there. They have to be dealt with. So we must know in each state who's foreigner, who's Indian. And that we'll do when we do an All India NRC. But at the moment, the first thing we'll do is for Assam, satisfy the Supreme Court, and then we'll do it for the other states.
I have two parts for which I want your response or reaction to it. One is basically to take off on what you were talking about the NRC, yes, where people have been urged and provoked to give wrong information or to give information at all.
Now, Arundhati.
whoever.
Not whoever, only one.
Yeah, Arundhati, and there's a lot of Muslim organizations.
Mamata Banerjee.
No, there are a lot of Muslim organizations over the last few weeks who have taken a lot of processions here. Yes. Where echoing the same thing.
Yes, yes.
Now, if, for example, my name doesn't figure in the NRC,
yes,
or I give wrong information, and therefore with other identities, cards or other identities that I might have, doesn't tally with the wrong information, I don't exist in the records as a citizen, which means I probably can't vote in the future. If something like that happens and a large mass of people do not figure to vote, what is the kind of response?
No.
That is
first what? Know the procedure.
Yeah.
You know, I'll stop you in this and then in the other second. When the NRC is completed, it will be published.
Correct.
Then you find your name is not there, you immediately put a petition, I'm a citizen. Yeah. How come my name is not there?
Okay.
And then the government has to hold an inquiry.
Okay.
Whether you are a citizen and what happened, why did you exclude it? And then satisfy you. And if you are a citizen, you will be put back in the list.
Okay.
It is not a final list unless it has been tested by inquiry.
Yeah. The second part is we were talking about the vibrancy of the democracy.
Yes.
You are saying that the so-called illiterate not withheld, upholded democracy where the... Now, I want your reaction on a statement which a writer had made. I mean, he is recently deceased. And he said, to uphold a vibrant democracy, we need a touch of autocracy.
You touch it?
Autocracy. Because you need to, somebody has to enforce democracy. So
no,
I want your reaction on that.
All the power that people in power can exercise is in the constitution. And you can't go beyond it. There's no touch or non-touch. We need a constitution. For instance, fundamental rights. Have you got complete freedom on fundamental rights? No. Fundamental rights to speak is subject to reasonable restrictions. If Article 19, bracket 1, bracket A gives you the fundamental right to speak, Article 19, bracket 2, prescribes the limits of your fundamental right to speak. You cannot say that I will break my country. That is there in the Constitution. But nobody reads 19 bracket 2. And they say, oh, this 19 bracket 1 is my fundamental right.
Yeah.
So, can I pray as I like? No, you can't. People said you can't abolish triple talaq because it's part of Islamic religion. And Article 25 gives me fundamental right to profess my religion. Yes, but it also says subject to reasonable restrictions. And one of the reasonable restrictions is equality of man and woman, and that is violated by triple talaq. So we got it dismissed.
Absolutely.
They went and challenged it in court, and it was got dismissed. So therefore, the constitution is very clear. There is no such thing as absolute fundamental right to do anything. They are all conditional fundamental rights.
Sir, my name is Meena Vishwanath. My question is that we are very much happy about the administration in the central level, all of that. But in Tamil Nadu, if you see, the electoral polls, most of the time, the anti-Modi sentiment is being spread so much that it is winning. So when will we have a very strong, charismatic BJP leader in Tamil Nadu? Because we all are very much dissatisfied.
When the central leadership asked me who should be the charismatic leader, then only it will improve. The present BJP can never improve.
This is Pratosh from Chennai. My question is for example, regarding the Citizenship Amendment Act or whatever it is, whatever happens, the Congress or the opposition, mainly our Buddhu, the Rahul Gandhi, says constitution is murdered, democracy is murdered. Except you, nobody is ready to give as you get. You have in your Twitter, I give as good as I get. No BJP person or nobody is not able to defend. I mean, they are not giving a clarity. Today you gave a wonderful speech. Hats off to you, sir. And the second thing is, regarding economy, again, what I feel or what others feel, majorly even in your followers and Twitter and everybody, when you become a finance minister, there is a chances that everything will turn. And another thing, though this is adversity, I would like to take it as an opportunity, being an optimistic person. Even though the economy is crumbled, I'm sure the time will force whoever it is, be it Modi or anybody, to make you a finance minister with your Paramacharya blessing and my best wishes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.